What is the difference between corrective action and preventive action? Corrective action is the action taken on causes of detected non-conformity. Whenever you talk about corrective action, you must talk about causes. Corrective action is action taken on causes of detected non-conformity to avoid reoccurrence. To avoid reoccurrence. That is corrective action, not the preventive action. I think many of the people told that as preventive action. Corrective action is the action taken on causes of detected non-conformity to avoid reoccurrence. Some of you have told correctly. Some people have told correctly that to avoid reoccurrence. Okay, that itself is a corrective action. Even if you implement POCI, okay, after the problem to avoid reoccurrence, then it's a corrective action, not a preventive action. Because problem is already occurred, then you find the reason that operator forgot, so you put the sensor, now the problem will not come, then it's a corrective action to avoid the reoccurrence, right? So if you see, if you try to understand this, you have non-conformity. You have non-conformity. One is taking action on the non-conformity. This action is correction. Another is your non-conformity and there are causes. And you take action on the causes. This is corrective action. One is taking action on the non-conformity. Another is action on the cause of the non-conformity. Action on the non-conformity is correction. Action on the causes of the detected non-conformity to avoid reoccurrence is corrective action. There is potential non-conformity. You have potential non-conformity. Causes of potential non-conformity. On cause you take action. That is preventive action. You have potential non-conformity, for that there are causes, and you take action on the causes of the potential non-conformity to avoid occurrence. To avoid occurrence. Whereas corrective action is to avoid reoccurrence. This is the basic difference. If customer complaint comes, then you implement POCI, okay, it's a corrective action. But before the problem, you anticipate and take action, then it's a preventive action. You getting it? Now, for example, brushing the teeth every day. Even though all your teeth are fine, no problem. You don't have any tooth problem. Then it's a preventive action. That action was taken in spite of that I had a teeth problem. Then I came to know the cause is not just ensuring that brushing, some more causes. Then I have taken an action to brush in the night compulsorily. Second, method of brushing, brush changing frequency. So I have taken 2-3 actions. After taking those actions, the problem did not repeat for several years. Not repeated. Means other teeth there is no problem. Now the action which I have taken is still a corrective action because problem has already occurred. If I would have taken these actions beforehand, provided I would not have had the teeth problem some years ago. Yes, based on RPN. Based on RPN, based on risk, based on potential problem. Many of the problems that we get because our FEMAs are weak. We don't anticipate problem and take action beforehand. So what happens? Finally problem comes, then we start taking action. If we do very good FEMAs, many of the potential problems and causes. See, you do cause and effect diagram during problem solving. Yes or no? Kisi story mein apne kiya hai cause and effect diagram? Yes or no? Yes, you all have done. Are you doing cause and effect diagram while doing FMEA? Whatever causes you are mentioning for the particular defect in your cause and effect diagram of problem solving QC story, whether those causes are also mentioned in FMEA? No. You can check. In FMEA, only few causes which has got control available are mentioned. FMEA is weak. If you do thorough FMEA, problem has not come. You have not missed the flight. You make a cause and effect diagram, missing the flight. I have not missed the flight so far, but I can make a cause and effect diagram. Why I will miss the flight? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 reason I can write. Starting late, route not known, getting stuck up in the traffic. Maybe driver not coming on time. Past data potential, need not be. It's technical knowledge, no? If you ask me, missing the flight or reaching to the airport late, causes, I can think and write, no? Technical knowledge, process knowledge. Potential problem, right? Problem has not occurred, but you can still think and write. So I'll write. Then I'll ask, for this, what is the control I have? For this, what is the control I have? For this, what is the control I have? Wherever control is not there, I take a action and identify control. But what happens is, while doing PFMEA, people don't do all this. Cause and effect diagram is not made, detailed analysis is not made. There is urgency of development, urgency of ensuring to hand over for the regular production. So CFT is not sitting and doing systematic analysis of PFMEA. Then what happens finally? When problem comes, then we upstream time for the development time. There, if you spend qualitative time, many of the problems which can come at later stage can be avoided. So those kind of things come under preventive action. Problem has not occurred, but you can anticipate. Now, operator has not forgotten the part, but we can think operator may forget this part. So what has to be done? Okay, here, to avoid that, we will put one sensor, one POCA, okay, or something, so that operator, before forgetting, we know that here he can forget. Part missing. After the part missing problem, people take corrective action. But why part missing? We know that operator has to assemble this many parts, sometime part missing can happen. Or interchanging of parts, using a wrong component. So using wrong component is known beforehand. Only thing is we have not taken action, so problem has come, now we take action. But such kind of things can be identified beforehand and take a action. That is preventive action. Another thing is, when you brainstorm and take action, after taking action, there can be some side effects, some other problem. To avoid that other problem, you can take action beforehand. For example, to maintain the angle, he is putting some not rod, something you will put in middle in the cargo to maintain particular angle for welding. That is the action he has taken. He has shown, after this action, my angle variation is reduced. Now my next question is, okay, angle variation is reduced. What are the other possible problems? Because earlier you are not putting this rod in between, now you are putting this rod. There can be dent damage on the product while putting, or person may forgot to put this while doing welding. What else can go wrong? Have you identified that? First question. Said, to avoid the dent damage, you have put the rubber pad. Rubber cushioning is given so that dent damage doesn't happen. Then it is a preventive action to avoid other problem of dents. And again, that rubber pad he has given, the next question is, you have put the rubber pad, will it remain same or will it wear out? It can wear out after some time. So do you have some checking frequency? Have you added in your maintenance plan that you will check this quality of this pad at this frequency or replace with at this frequency? If not, add that. That is a preventive action, because that problem has not yet occurred. The pad is still okay, but you are taking action to check it at regular basis and ensure that is maintained. That is preventive action. So just to give you an example, there is a problem of gear mix-up. It was supplied to the customer. Customer has given a complaint. Then, what was the cause for that mix-up of gear? They have identified that reason is person who is making doing packing, similar looking gears he packed. He could not identify. Since he could not identify, then they decided to punch the number. Okay, number will be punched on it. This is the action taken. So this action will avoid the problem of mix-up because person can see the number on that while packing, so there is no confusion. This problem will get resolved, but the process is changed. Earlier punching was not there, now punching is added. What are the other problems because of this action? He can do wrong punching. Then, what else? Yes, please. He can do wrong punching. Yes, teeth may get damaged during the punching. There can be dent, there can be damage. Forgot to punch. Punching on wrong location. Right? So there can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different problems which can occur. Those problems have not yet come, but we take action beforehand. Then, it's a preventive action for those problems which has not yet come. For every action, you must write what are the potential problems. If there are, you must write that. By taking this action, this kind of potential problem may come. If not coming, you must write as a CFT that no problem can come because of this action. If any potential problem can come, you must write. We are going to take as a green belt, we are going to take for our project this action. And this action may lead to this kind of problem. To avoid that problem also, we have taken the action. Otherwise, you will solve one problem, create another problem. I am telling you from my past experience. He is showing me the data. 0000. Suddenly from here rejection started. You must analyze what is changed. Why suddenly started. Because this is not it was not there earlier. So only analyze what is changed. That will solve your problem, I told. He told, I know that. What is changed? Ask what? That other person has done project and all people have appreciated that project. That project has created this problem. That change was done and this problem started. So now this is another project. You are getting it? I am telling you from practical experience. So, you should not give chance to do one more project based on your project. Right? So you must analyze, if I take this action, what potential problem can occur and take action. That is preventive action. Is it clear now? Corrective action and preventive action. Correction, action on the non-conformity. Corrective action, action on the causes of detected non-conformity to avoid reoccurrence. Corrective action impact, horizontal deployment of corrective action. Same action for similar products. Same action for similar processes, similar machines, then it's corrective action impact. Preventive action, action taken on causes of potential non-conformity to avoid occurrence. Okay, here I have talked only about non-conformity. ISO standard talks about non-conformity or other undesirable situation. It doesn't say only non-conformity. Non-conformity or other undesirable situation. Undesirable situation can be breakdown. It's not a non-conformity. Suppose breakdown. You take a corrective action on the breakdown also. Or it can be accident. It can be like reaching late to the airport. Corrective action can be on undesirable situation also. Need not be always a non-conformity. If you refer the definition given in the ISO standard, it says, corrective action is the action taken on causes of detected non-conformity or other undesirable situations. Utta specific diya hai usme. Okay? It need not be only on the non-conformity to avoid reoccurrence. And preventive action is action taken on causes of detected non-conformity or other undesirable situation to avoid occurrence. escape, occur and systemic. Three types of causes. Escape cause means why it is not detected, why it has gone to the next station. This is cause of non-detection. That is escape cause of non-detection. Why it is not detected? Why problem has gone to the next station or customer? You may implement some POKI-OKI or detection method to ensure that it is detected here and it is not passed to the subsequent station. Such kind of actions is action on the escape cause. But it will not solve the problem completely because it will only detect and ensure that it is not passed. Like bad part coming to you, supplier starts detecting it, then it will not come to you, but it is still getting rejected at supplier end. Right? Occurrence or occur root cause. Here, cause of generation. Why it is generated? Why it is produced? Why bad part is made? That is occur root cause. And if you take action on this, the generation will stop. It will not occur again. Right? That is cause of generation. Now, systemic cause is about what needs to be corrected in our quality system. If system is not correct, that's why this has occurred. System is not perfect, that's why this is passed to the next station. So what has to be done? Say, for example, if part missing is a problem, I implement POKI-OKI to detect the part missing. Then final stage will detect if part missing, it will not give OK signal. Then escape cause caper action here. Part missing, why? Operator forgot, suppose, is the cause. Generation stage. Unless part is not fit, the operation will not be completed. Now part missing, part cannot be produced. Then you have taken action on the occur cause. Systemic, what needs to be corrected in the system because of which it is generated or produced? Lessons learnt. Your technical lesson learnt. The team had done a project to reduce the design scrap in the injection molding. The material which is getting scrapped, design scrap, by design that much scrap is going to happen. So those material scrap they have reduced without making major change in the mold and, you know, without incurring too much of cost, with some less cost, maybe 1000 or 500 or something like that. That cost they have done some changes and the problem is solved and reduced. Scrap cost is reduced. Okay, it was innovative idea and all that. Then I asked, have you implemented horizontally on other products? I said, yes. This product we have implemented, this is the benefit, and these are the other products we have implemented so far, and these are the other products still we are in process of implementation. Okay, that is good. Then I asked, have you changed the new product development procedure? And they did not get it. Why I am asking this question? I asked them, you have done improvement now? They said, yes, good. This improvement was not done during the development stage. I said, yes. Why it was not done? Because you are not knowing that this is the best way. This way is going to reduce the design scrap. You are not knowing during the development. If you knew what during development, you would have done that time only. Now, lesson learnt is, during next development, what change has to be done? That should go to your development system. So that it can be corrected. Suppose you are saying there was a design error and you correct the design. Now yesterday I was showing you leakage problem. Right? I am showing you one problem, leakage, and I am showing you Pareto, no? Operator wise, assembly operator, testing operator wise, leakage. You know, after all the analysis in that project, you know what was found? What was found was, after torquing, the part flatness gets disturbed. Incoming part flatness gets disturbed after torquing. Because the flatness is not good, there is a leakage. Action taken is to increase the thickness of the part so that with that much torque also the flatness will not get disturbed. Thickness is increased, then the problem became zero. Okay, now the action is taken, problem becomes zero. But what is the lesson learnt here? For what thickness, what torque, or what torque, what should be the thickness? That is not known to the designer. Right. Now, next development also, somebody will give some thickness and based on torque, some torque, and finally we will get problem and we have to again solve it. Rather than that, what is the system? We have to say, as a system, for this much torque, this much thickness, this much torque, this much thickness, standard has to be prepared, should be used for the next development. Then you have taken action on the systemic root cause. Rarely people think from this direction, very rarely. People solve the problem. They don't think of systemic root cause. Isko thoda sochna padta hai, system mein kya theek karna hai. Not about this product or this process. What has to be corrected in the system so that this problem do not occur in the next project also. You have to compulsorily write what is a technical lesson learnt and should give a feedback to the development or design or jo bhi change kiya aapne usme, so that that can be incorporated. For example, problem has come, now you have implemented poker, okay, problem is solved. Learning is next design and development stage. This kind of operation requires poker, okay. It should be incorporated in the process so that this kind of operations, POCAUK should be incorporated. Then you have taken action on the system. Clear? So the lesson learned should be technical. Otherwise, log generic lesson likhte hai. I have seen QC story mein generic lesson likhte hai. Lesson learned. QC story can solve any kind of problem. Chote chote action se bade bade problem solve ho jate hai. Aisa philosophical funda lesson likh dete hai. What is the exact lesson learned from your project? Right? You are getting it or not? Exact technically you have done some changes now. That's why problem is solved. That lesson is systemic cause.